All right, new questions tonight about the safety of our pets when we send them off to the groomer. And a warning tonight about this story. Some of the images are graphic because a Springfield man says that his dog was badly injured. The 22 News I-Team discovered that in Massachusetts, your pet groomer doesn't need certification or any type of licensing. But there are renewed efforts now to change that.
Literally has a red muzzle.
Josh Fontanez of Springfield never thought a routine trip to their pet groomer would leave him rushing his 5-year-old Maltese Brady to an emergency veterinary hospital.
You mentioned too that the kids saw him when he initially came home. That must have been pretty scary for them.
They were freaked out. My oldest, my 9-year-old, he's like a super empath, even with people, with dogs, anybody, kids. And he felt really bad. He was crying that night.
Their groomer, which the 22 News I-Team is not publicly identifying right now, described the incident as a minor accident.
And I'm like, oh my God, like what happened? They're like, well, we went to go kind of trim around his face and he stuck his tongue on it. We nicked his tongue.
Fontanez contends it was more than a nick. He contacted 22 News and provided the I-Team with this picture he took of Brady in the moments after a portion of his dog's tongue was snipped off. He managed to stop the bleeding and rush little Brady to an emergency pet clinic, but treatment for this type of injury is limited. The vet sent Brady home with a cone on his head.
You don't need a license to be a pet groomer in Massachusetts. State lawmakers here in Boston tried to pass legislation to change that. In fact, the 22 News I-Team learned that a former state house representative from Western Massachusetts pushed for regulatory controls over the pet grooming industry back in 2013.
From what I understand, you believe that having some sort of regulation would be beneficial for the pet owner and also for the groomer. It can protect the groomer.
Yes. We just expect the groomer to hold themselves out as a groomer, that they might have a license. The state has monitored them for the hygiene, the proper hygiene, the proper tools, and a background check, right? But that's not the case.
Cheryl Coakley Rivera is a pet owner herself. She rescues dogs, so her passion is personal. Right now, she serves as the Hampden County Registry of Deeds. But in her role as a state house representative, she authored House Bill 680. She cited a case of animal abuse in Wilbraham where a dog groomer killed a poodle in her care and later confessed to the crime as her motivation for drafting that bill.
Obviously, she was arrested and so forth, but she was able to open again.
Coakley Rivera's bill included a list of more than 50 regulations like licensing requirements, yearly inspections of grooming facilities, also restrictions of the use of cage or box dryers where heaters are used to dry a dog's coat while crated. She's hoping that current representation in Boston will once again take up the issue in the next session. As for Josh Fontanez, he says little Brady is back to his energetic self, and for now, he gets doggy baths at home.
Are you going to be going back to that pet groomer?
Definitely not.
So I talked with current state representative Carlos Gonzalez, and he told me that told the I-Team that he plans to draft new legislation this December that builds on that original bill. So to be continued, we'll keep you posted.